Hello, dear listeners, viewers of Africa Media Malta, welcome to our roundup of African news. Today we'll go to Ivory Coast, where the President Alassane Ouattara has announced his intention to seek a third term, although the constitution limits the presidency to two terms. We'll also briefly mention Guinea-Conakry, where the syndrome of life presidency seems to have touched Alpha Condé, the incumbent president. We will close our roundup with the coup in Mali, which led to the resignation of the President Ibrahim Boubacar Keïta. Stay with us. In Ivory Coast, as it was sadly predictable, five people have lost their lives during protests organized by the civil society against the third term of the President Alassane Ouattara. Ado made the move on the 6th August, officially announcing his candidacy to run for a third term, a declaration which came as no surprise for the followers of the African politics. The U-turn came only 5 months after he had gathered the press to declare that he would not seek a third term. The change in the constitution operated in 2016 stipulated a maximum of 2 terms. In a tweet, Ouattara said that no one better than him knows what is written in the constitution. His legal supporters explained that Ouattara is not breaching any constitutional law. They say his candidacy will actually be the first in the Third Republic of Ivory Coast. The opposition refutes the argument and accuses a constitutional coup. Ouattara was elected in 2010 after a controversial campaign against Laurent Gbagbo that had plunged the country into a deadly civil unrest which had caused over 3,000 deaths. Let's cross the border and go to Guinea-Conakry, where another president is under fire for the same reason. The 82-year-old Alpha Condé is the peak of his political party to be the candidate for the presidential election scheduled for this year. A referendum organized in March and boycotted by the opposition had allowed the revision of the constitution, which could open the possibility to Condé for a third spell. Protests against him have caused at least 30 deaths. In Mali, the President Ibrahim Boubacar Keïta announced his resignation this Tuesday. It's the result of a political crisis that has rocked the country for months. Led by Imam Sako, a religious and opposition figure, protests pushed pressure on Malian institutions accused of incapacity and corruption. The West African country suffers attacks from jihadists and terrorists. Keïta was forced to resign after being arrested by the army. In a televised message, Colonel Major Ismael Ouag promised the prompt establishment of working institutions. It's difficult to be positive when dealing with African news. It seems that the old demons of coups and life presidents are insensitive to any exorcism. And yet, the African Union 2063 agenda is a promise of a better future for the continent. Dear listeners and viewers, thank you for the attention and bye from now.